Well, actually, my husband found an ad in the paper about a peripheral neuropathy kind of class or seminar.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he's a retired MD, so he's searching for ways to help me with my peripheral neuropathy. And as an RN, I have an open mind to health issues anyway.
Great, good. And what kind of problems did you have before you came to the office?
The worst part of my peripheral neuropathy was the fact that I would get these stabbing pains in my legs and up from the bottom of my feet, and they would wake me up and keep me up almost all night. All I wanted to do basically was just lay in bed because I had no energy, I wasn't sleeping, I was in so much pain. And the physicians I went to would put me on different kinds of medications. But the medications not only didn't help, I didn't like the way the medications made me feel.
And so you came in, and when we did the evaluation, did we treat you properly, respectful, professionally? Did you feel that way, how we were with you?
Oh, I felt real comfortable with all that. But my biggest concern, because I had so many health issues in so many areas, with my lung cancer, my COPD, my diabetes, on and on, that you wouldn't accept me.
Right.
That's what I really thought was going to happen.
Right. When you first came to me, you were pretty much bound to a walker, right? You couldn't get away without that. And then you were also on oxygen pretty much all the time as well.
24/7 on oxygen.
Right. And so here we are some months later, and tell us how you're doing now.
I don't use the walker very much anymore, except for convenience if I'm going to be going a long way and I know that I need it for sitting down.
Right.
But I don't need it for walking because I use a cane, but I really don't have to have it either. That's more or less just a safety issue.
Right, yeah. And then how often are you using the oxygen now?
Well, the oxygen's gone from 24/7 to... On occasion,
right. And so when I saw you walk in here the other day without the oxygen, and I think you were holding the cane in your hand and you were just walking, I was so happy to see that. And your balance is better, your breathing's better, your blood sugar's better. So an awful lot of things got improved, more than just the peripheral neuropathy. Is that correct?
That's correct.
That's great. So,
very much so. In fact, I'm now looking forward to traveling to Oklahoma for a grandson's wedding, which traveling anywhere was out of the question before.
Right.
Mainly I was suffering from the peripheral neuropathy.
Mm-hmm.
The foot and the leg pain was the biggest problem.
Okay.
I couldn't sleep at night. And I was hoping to get off the medications, and I was trying acupuncture before I met you.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to a chiropractor for some treatment.
Okay.
And I needed to get off the pain, that wasn't relieving the pain very, very much. So
right.
I was pretty impressed with all the testimony from all the previous patients.
Mm-hmm.
And you were pretty straightforward. I liked your presentation. I figured that would be something I wanted to give a try. I'm feeling much better. My energy level is up. My pain level is probably about a 4.
Okay.
Or maybe a 3
at
night.
Great.
I used to have the pain that was a 9 or a 10. And so I'm able to rest and sleep better, and I can go through most of the day without any pain most days.
Wonderful.
And then at night, a little bit of discomfort, which is normal.
Right.
But not nearly as bad as it was.
So good.
It's much, much better.
Fabulous. And so you've dropped a little bit of weight since you've been here?
15 pounds so far.
Excellent. Very good. And you weren't a chubby guy either, huh?
I feel good about that.
Excellent.
Good, yeah.
And then also part of the issue was blood sugar. You were having, you're diabetic and you take medication. And so what's happened to your blood sugar since you've been coming here?
I've been looking at the numbers every morning, and it's consistently low now.
Excellent.
By, I would say, over 20, 25 points on average.
Wonderful. Good.
And it's staying at a pretty level.
Beautiful. And if I remember correctly, you're talking to your physician about dropping some of the meds. Is that right?
That's exactly right. Yeah.
Awesome. Good for you, Bill.
I would say this program is worth a try. It worked great for me. I would highly recommend it. I've already recommended it to several people.
Very good.
So hopefully they'll come see you.
Very good.
It works.
Very good. Well, hey, Bill, you sure been a great guy to work with, and I sure appreciate your attitude. And, oh, yeah, another quick question here. You mentioned that you're sure enjoying the golf game now, huh?
Oh, it's much better.
Much better, yeah.
Yeah, I'm playing consistently at least once a week, and the game's getting better. I'm not exhausted by the end of the round like I used to be.
Excellent. And your balance is better, and you're hitting the ball better. Good. Mm-hmm. So for all our golfers out there, they'll want to know about that. So.
It was a neuropathy doctor for nerves, and my left leg, he said, more or less was dead when he hit the joint. And I said, well, what the hell do we do about it? And he said, well, take this pill and then come back and see me. Well, I never took the pill. And then my wife, who does a lot of searching on the internet, she found Dr. Harper in Oceanside. So we went to the presentation, and, you know, here we are today, mm-hmm. feeling much better, and can't say enough.
Good.
Very self-explanatory. Yes, everything was in writing. You allowed me to ask questions that concerned me, which was important, because a lot of other places I went to, they wouldn't let me ask questions. They just wanted to give me a pill and send me out the door. But you guys showed a lot more concern, and I felt like you guys cared about me and wanted me to get well, and that's what I was looking for, somebody that cared. For the reason of coming here all these months, it kind of paid off, because I got to run up the hill there in Oceanside with my dog, and I beat my dog, and I haven't been able to run for probably 2 years. And I'm not talking about a long distance, I'm talking about a sprint. If there was an emergency, I could get myself to the right place and take care of myself. Before, I don't think I could have. I would have went maybe 20 yards and been out of gas, and my leg would have been hurting. I would have had to sit down. It was not good.
No. But and now you can run a hill?
Oh, yes. Yes, I could. I can take care of myself, and that was my whole goal in coming here, is when I wanted to feel better and take care of myself.
Great. And along with working with the peripheral neuropathy, we worked a lot with your general health, right?
Yes.
You were borderline diabetic. You were on high blood pressure medicine. And you just showed me a piece of paper that your physician wrote something on that paper. What did he write?
No more pills.
No more pills.
No more drugs.
All those medications that you were on for other problems.
Yes.
He did your blood work, and you actually shared that he said your blood work's better than his.
Right.
Yeah, all right, yeah. Very good. That's excellent. Well, and that's great, Craig, because that was one of your goals, was to get off all your meds, right?
That was more or less. For that, my main goal was my meds and my walking. I wanted to walk.
Good. That's great. How old are you, Craig?
I'm 59 years old.
59 years old. And at this age, you can still get better and healthy. Isn't that amazing? Good deal.
This is a way of life I can live with. It's tolerable. My wife's on the program. We work together at it. It's like it's drawing us a little closer together, because now we're more of a team on the things that we do.
Beautiful. Great.
Welcome. I consider it an honor to be able to address you today to share all the information that I've gathered in over 31 years of practice and over 7,500 patients of practice. I have been able to come up with this amazing ways how to help people with peripheral neuropathy. I'm going to share with you right now all the ways that we help people with peripheral neuropathy, and you can join the thousands that have gotten better and gotten rid of the problems from all across the United States and Mexico. Can you imagine getting rid of that tingling, the numbness, the burning, the inability to sleep because of the pain, walking on glass symptoms, the loss of balance, the swelling, wounds that don't heal, the problems with your toenails, the discoloration? All those things could be gone, and they could be gone naturally. You know, you don't have to resort to dangerous drug shots and surgeries with all those dangerous side effects. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take time, we're going to go over this, sit back, relax, and I'm so glad that I get to be here with you. I'm Dr. John Harper from beautiful Oceanside, California. I absolutely love what I do, and I love sharing this information with everybody. So let's get going. So, what is peripheral neuropathy? What causes it? And most importantly, what are we going to do to restore your nerves to get healthy? So, like I said, I've been in private practice in Oceanside since 1986, privately consulted, examined, and treated over 7,500 patients in that time. I'm a board member of the American Functional Neurology Institute. I've been granted numerous awards and certifications in my 31 years of practice. I regularly attend conferences because I want to stay on top of the best, most cutting-edge research, diagnostics, and protocols to bring to my patients. Research shows that most physicians are 17 years behind in the research. You know, that's somebody that's doing something from the year 2000. You know, I want to know what's going on in 2017, and as we go into the future, I promise you I'll continue to do that. I am a third generation Southern Californian. We actually have had figured out we've had five generations of Californians living right here in Oceanside. I'm just so blessed. I have four children and five grandkids at the time of this shooting here. And right here, this is one of my grandkids and one of my favorite pictures of me holding one of my kids here, grandkids. So life is great. I get to do what I love to do in helping people, and I get to be around my kids and grandkids as well. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about my story. First of all, I was scheduled at age 21 for back surgery, and I was told that there was a 10% chance of being paralyzed from the waist down for the rest of my life from the surgery. A good friend of mine, he recommended that I go see a chiropractor. And when I asked him, well, what does a chiropractor do? Because I'd never heard of such a thing. He said, well, a chiropractor is a doctor that works with your natural body, your body's natural ability to get better. And I'm so glad he didn't say that was somebody who cracks your back, because I would have never done anything like that. So what I do now is that I had another health problem, and then both my parents had health problems that I had to know a lot more than just chiropractic. And so that's how I got involved with functional medicine and functional neurology. And I'm going to completely explain all that to you. I think it's important that you understand that I come from a personal experience of needing help and finding it from the right kind of a doctor. And I've also learned to help my family and also all my patients for the same means. So peripheral neuropathy, it's very common, affects about 20 million people in the United States. Essentially, the electrical wiring in your body's breaking down. Your feet and hands can't communicate to the brain, and your brain can't communicate to your feet and hands. Now, I've had patients that just started off with a little bit of tickles or tingling in their toes, but then it ended up in their hands, in their face, in their groin. And so this is nothing to be messing around with. This is a progressive degenerative problem that just gets worse. That just means that right now your symptoms are the tip of the iceberg until you can get to the underlying cause and actually correct that. Here's the nervous system. Here's your brain, spinal cord, and everything else that you see is considered a peripheral nerve. So most people associate peripheral neuropathy with their feet and hands, but you can have it in any part of your body. So what are the signs and signals that you have peripheral neuropathy? Well, like we said, there's numbness, burning feet, cramping, sharp electric pain, pain when walking, difficulty sleeping from leg discomfort. That's really bad because your body needs to get to sleep. That's when your body repairs itself. So if you're not sleeping, not only are you having yourself be cranky in the morning, but you're literally keeping your body from healing, and you're actually growing older than you're supposed to much faster. The prickling, tingling sensations, loss of balance. This is very dangerous. The number one cause of accidental death in the United States, falling. So you don't want to have on your tombstone, I fell down. We also have weakness, and then again, swelling. These are pretty much the top 10 signs of peripheral neuropathy. So what causes the symptoms? Well, if you look here, here's a nerve, and it actually has proper blood supply. And right here we see a nerve that's starting to become sick because it's starting to lose the blood supply. And right here we see a nerve that's pretty much dead because there is no blood supply for the nerve. So this is what happens to the nerve. Now, I wanted to show you here a little more specifically. So when you look right here, I'm going to use this wire here, and when we look at a nerve, especially coming out of the spine, as you can see, it's got a bunch of little wires in it, and then it has this covering around it, and that's called the myelin sheath. So when you have proper blood supply, no pressure on the nerve, when the body is getting the nerve everything that it needs, the nerve functions properly. But what happens is that when the nerve isn't taken care of properly, the myelin sheath just starts to peel off. That covering, the insulation for the nerve, just starts to come off. So now what's happening is you have bare wires, and they're actually sitting in salt water. We're salty on the inside. So now what's happening, these bare wires sitting in the salt water, is causing short circuiting. That short circuiting is giving you the tingling, the numbness, the burning. It's keeping your body from being able to talk to the different parts of the body to tell how the nerves are supposed to work. So what I do in my office is we get to the underlying cause of this problem, and then the body naturally just puts that myelin sheath back on the nerves. And when we do that, that allows the nerves to go back and just function the way they're supposed to. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Here you have your symptoms of maybe problems in your feet or your hands, but more equally as important is there's a research article that came out in a journal, medical journal, and it says, what happens to your brain when you can't feel your feet? So what happens is that it changes your brain. And so what they found out from this study is that with people with peripheral neuropathy in their hands or feet would lose their balance. Well, you know, that kind of makes sense. You can't feel the ground, can't feel your feet, you're gonna lose your balance. But your brain is built for information. It's built to absorb information coming from your body to your brain. So it causes memory loss, depression, anxiety, Alzheimer's disease, dementia, insomnia. So when I have patients that come to me and complain about these other things, one of the first things I ask them is, how long has your feet or hands been tingling or numb or burning? And they look at me like I've been peeking in their windows at night. It's because we know that this causes damage to the brain. So again, this progressive degenerative problem of the nerves going bad is bad for you. It's more than just the symptoms. It actually affects your brain. And these are a lot of the problems that most people in America are suffering from. So let me ask you a question here. 30% of all energy of your body goes to what system? Is it the endocrine, digestive, nervous system, immune system, or cardiovascular system? Which one is it? Well, it's the nervous system, your brain, spine, and spinal cord, and nerves. See, we need a proper metabolism, which is energy, for a well-functioning brain and nerves. Metabolic problems lead to peripheral neuropathy. So what does this mean? Well, almost a full third of the energy that your body creates is used by the nervous system to function, make the nervous system function properly. It is so important that we are able to, through the circulation, get the body what it needs. Otherwise, the nerves start to become damaged, lose that myelin sheath, and then we start having problems. So let me simplify what I mean by metabolism. You eat food and you turn it into energy. Now that kind of simplifies the 10,000 chemical reactions a minute that your body has to do, but this is exactly how that works. So all chronic illnesses are a combination of neurological and metabolic problems that requires proper metabolic and neurological treatment. So let's take a minute here and go over to what I call the magic board, and we'll explain this a little bit more. So here we are at the magic board. And why is this magic? Because this is the magic of how I get patients better. This is how I explain why I do works. And this makes sense to me, and it makes sense to every single one of my patients. So let's do this. So there's a metabolic side. There's a chemical part to your body. This is you eating your food and turning it to energy. Here's the neurological side. This is your brain, your nervous system, your peripheral nerves, your spinal cord. This is what directs everything to happen. Your brain tells your body how to take that food and turn it into energy. But your brain and your nervous system uses a full third of that energy. So what ends up happening is that these two things are intertwined. What the brain does to tell the body to make the energy has to make the energy for the brain and the nervous system and the peripheral nerves. Does that make sense? Makes sense to me. So this is what happens. Let's say there's an injury. Doesn't matter where it is, Doesn't matter if it's your back, your knee, something happens to you. Something causes a problem and it doesn't allow the body to work the way it was meant to. So let's say it causes you to not exercise as much as you should. So not exercising causes a problem with your brain. Your body needs some sort of exercise. So if you're not exercising, this causes problems with your neurological system. If your neurological system, if your brain and your nervous system isn't working right, it can't tell the metabolic, it can't tell your body how to do the metabolism right. And so that's going to go down. Now, if the metabolic side goes down and doesn't produce the energy that the brain and nervous system needs, that's going to cause this to go down. All right? So let's say this is a symptom, and we'll call this brain fog. Okay? So you go to your doctor and you say, oh, I got some brain fog. All right? I'm not really doing that. So you'll get some medication to cover up the brain fog. And let's say you come on over here and your body, your neurological system is not telling the body how to create food properly. And let's say it's in your stomach and you start getting some heartburn, or you get some acid reflux. And so then you're given some antacid to cover up that symptom. Well, but the medication that you take over here further doesn't let you digest your food properly. You know, if you take an antacid or something for acid reflux, it wipes out the acid in your stomach. Well, you need that acid to break down your food, don't you? And so now your food's not getting done, and so this creates another problem. So now you start becoming depressed. And you say, oh, doctor, I'm depressed. Well, then you get another medication that you take for that. Well, that medication causes its own symptoms, and that further depresses the neurological system. So can you see that you go, oh, well, now I got this knee pain, or I got this back pain. So what's happening is you keep taking medications that keep causing problems on both sides. And it was kind of interesting when I was explaining this to a patient a couple years ago, as he was looking at these down arrows, he says, oh my gosh, doc, it's the race to hell. I said, oh, that's good. I'm going to write that down. And so it is. Because when you keep covering up your symptoms, all right, you're just covering up your symptoms. You're just hiding the chronic problem, and it just keeps getting worse. So what I do that's different is we look at you metabolically, neurologically, and we address whatever this injury was structurally, and we address all three at the same time. So what happens now? So as we address you metabolically, that makes that a little better. Well, that's going to make the neurology a little bit better. And then that's going to make the metabolic side better. This is going to make this side better, and like that. And so what ends up happening, instead of having this problem with injury, what you're going to end up with is real, true health. Not just a bunch of covered up symptoms, not just a bunch of side effects from these drugs, and you won't be ending up with a chronic health problem that will at some point require really drastic things like shots and surgeries. So this is why we address the metabolic and the neurological sides at the same time with the structural, because we want to get you back to true health. Amazing, huh? Makes sense, doesn't it? Makes sense to me. Welcome back. I'm glad that we got to take a look over at the magic board and go over that information so you can really clearly understand what I mean by proper metabolic and neurological treatment. So the leading causes of peripheral neuropathy are statin drugs, those are cholesterol-lowering drugs, uncorrected damaged back or neck, that leads to spinal degeneration, type 2 diabetes or insulin resistance, chronic inflammation, and chemotherapy. So statins inhibit the formation of cholesterol. Now cholesterol makes up the sheath, that covering that we talked about, the myelin sheath of the nerve. Statin drugs also inhibit the formation of CoQ10 enzyme. CoQ10 enzyme is necessary for nerves to function. Statin drugs are the number one leading cause of peripheral neuropathy. That may be very shocking to you because the vast majority of Americans are on this silly drug. Now, let me go over a few things here with you. A study from the Neurology Journal in May 2002 said that the statins, the cholesterol drugs, they increase the risk of peripheral neuropathy 16 times. That's a 1,600% chance of damage to your nerves from those statins. Now, let's talk a little bit about this, about statin drugs. Now, I know most of you are under the impression that you got to do this or else you're going to get a heart attack or a stroke. Well, you need cholesterol for proper nerve function and brain function. Cholesterol will never clog your arteries unless you're inflamed. Now, I'm going to be very clear about what I mean by inflammation and inflamed on the inside. Inflammation is the real problem. It is not cholesterol. So why do doctors prescribe useless drugs that have such health consequences? Well, they're in a bad system. And to kind of let you know about this bad system, I'm going to have you watch this little short video here on a very important documentary on our, quote, healthcare crisis.
The American healthcare system is badly broken.
The present system doesn't work, and it's going to take us down. We need a whole new kind of medicine.
We're in the grip of a very big industry, and it doesn't want to stop making money.
If I spend 5 minutes with you and then put in one of these stents, I'd probably get paid $1,500. For me to spend 45 minutes with a patient to try to figure out what their true problem is, I'd probably get paid $15. It's a completely irrational system.
We don't have a healthcare system in this country. We have a disease management system.
We're spending almost twice as much in America as any other country on earth, but our lifespan isn't even in the top 20.
30,000 Medicare recipients die each year from care they didn't need.
That's the equivalent of a jumbo jet crashing every single week. If the aviation industry killed as many people, we'd be up in arms.
The administration pays you based on how many patients you see. All right, who's next? If you try and buck the system, someone says, "What can we do to get your productivity up?" I'm not interested in getting my productivity up. I'm interested in helping patients.
We're seeing the military just being a microcosm of the problems society's having.
Soldiers' use of prescription drugs has tripled in the past 5 years.
This medication's I was on.
Only by accepting that the American healthcare system is badly broken will we be able to seek out the escape fires, the potential solutions. There are answers.
One company has figured out how to lower healthcare costs by more than 40%.
We provide incentives for people to engage in healthier behaviors.
The Army Surgeon General directed that we establish the Pain Management Task Force to take a look at alternatives to narcotics.
I was skeptical, so skeptical.
I've gotten a lot of inspiration, a different perspective. There's a different way of doing things that is possible.
If I think about what healthcare could be like, it would have a lot more care in it.
The healthcare system is unsustainable. We're really mortgaging the future. Not just the health of healthcare, we're talking about the health of the nation.
It's a shame that we have to have this kind of thing, isn't it? But I'm going to let you know there's an alternative, and you can have hope because of what we do here in our office. So what's the second thing is a damaged neck and low back can contribute to peripheral neuropathy. See, things like stenosis, degenerative or bulging discs, degenerative arthritis, they all have one thing in common. See, the common traits of a damaged spine. Your spine can be compressed, and then that places pressure on the nerves. And if these are the nerves that are in your back, well, those go into your legs and your feet. If they're the nerves in your neck, they go into your arms and your hands. So this is another reason why we can get problems with peripheral neuropathy. Now, one of the main things that we use in our office, or what we actually say, one of our many weapons in our peripheral neuropathy recovery program arsenal, is non-surgical spinal decompression. As you can see here, person, if this is the problems in the back, you lie with a brace around here. There's a cable connected to a computer, and in that computer we put information about you specifically, and then what happens is this table separates a little bit, and this opens up the space there. So by doing that, well, here, let me just show you. See, here's a person lying on the table, and as the animation shows, this area starts to come slide apart. And then what happens, you can see that the spine is actually being pulled apart, and that is creating oxygen and nutrition, the fluid, to go into that space. Let's take a look at that one more time. So as the cable starts to pull on the computer, it gently pulls on your spine, creates a negative pressure, sucks oxygen and nutrition into that spine, and this causes the healing. Now, I wish I could tell you that's what it's going to do in one visit. Unfortunately, it takes periods of time, because the damage that's in your spine, that took a long time to get there as well. So this is an example of a patient, this gentleman, Jim. Jim, when he first came to me, he had a real hard time just walking, terrible peripheral neuropathy, terrible problems in his feet, legs, weakness, a lot of trouble. And as you look here where these arrows are, that's where there's supposed to be a disc space. There's very little space right there at all. So after 4.5 months, we did another x-ray, and because of using the decompression and some of the other things, look at those disc spaces. Much better, much bigger. And Jim went from, like I said, hardly being able to walk. The gentleman plays 2 rounds of golf, walks the course 18 holes a week. That's a huge difference. And so we're very excited and happy for Jim. Again, another one of all the many, many patients that come to our office and get really great results. So let's move on to diabetes and insulin resistance. So like we said, the nerves need lots of energy to survive. Glucose is the nerve's number one source of energy. So insulin's the hormone that puts it into the nerve. So if you're diabetic or insulin resistance, the sugar can't get inside to the nerve, and then this causes the nerves to fatigue, to get tired. So this is what causes the numbness, the burning, pain, weakness, and tingling as that myelin sheath starts to come off the nerve. Here we are to chronic inflammation. Inflammation means to ignite or to actually burst into flames. And you can't build a house that's on fire. I think if I saw somebody over here changing that window while the house is on fire, I would think that person's insane. And the issue is that if you have inflammation in your body and you're trying to do something to heal your body without getting rid of the inflammation, well, you're just as loco as this person that's trying to change the window on a house that's burning. You've got to get rid of the inflammation. It is so critical and important. So common causes of inflammation that contribute to peripheral neuropathy, food sensitivities, things that you're sensitive or allergic to, but maybe not even have big giant symptoms to. Maybe there's certain foods that you eat that are inflammatory to you. Poor food choices, junk food, things like that. Hidden gut infections, high insulin, hormone imbalances. All these things can cause inflammation in your body, and we got to get to the underlying cause of why that is. How do we do that? Well, metabolic causes need to be addressed if you're going to win the battle against peripheral neuropathy, and we got to do specialized blood work. I use a very specialized panel. Most physicians, when they run a panel for a patient, it's only maybe 15, 16 tests. My tests are 60. 60 tests, right? 4 times the amount. And I don't look at them like physicians do. I don't look and say, oh, your glucose is high, so you're going to take this metformin. Oh, your cholesterol is high, so you're going to take this drug. We don't do that. I look them at as a whole. So let me explain what I mean. Have you been told that all your lab tests are normal? Well, lab ranges are first of all inaccurate, and they use bell curves. Functional lab values are much more sensitive to reveal problems. So what do we mean? So what happens is every year the lab results of all these labs across the United States are sent into a central organization, and they average it. Well, And this is how they come up with their ranges. Well, that doesn't make any sense to me, because if that's what they do, this is an average of sick people. This is who goes into the go to the doctor and get labs, is people who aren't feeling well. So we don't want people that are just not dead. We want people that are healthy. So this is what I do. I use functional labs. And let me explain to you. So here's your abnormal low values, and then here's your abnormal high. So this would be considered the normal. So here's your bell curve, down here, like that, and then across here. But in these areas, you'll find problems that lead to bigger problems. By using these functional lab ranges, our lab ranges are much more sensitive to problems, and we can get to them much sooner and fix them before they become a permanent problem. So, for instance, you look here at the glucose. The traditional high range is 65 to 110. I use 85 to 100, a much more reasonable, narrow range. So if you were 73 with your physician's ranges, you'd be considered normal. But 73 is much too low of blood sugar. So this is what's contributing to the issue of the peripheral neuropathy or even other health problems. So this is why we use the functional ranges. So what else does a neuron need to revive and repair? Well, we said good glucose, needs good oxygen, blood supply, no inflammation, and it needs lots and lots of activation. Here's my little nervous system guy working out. I really, really going to town there. You got to activate the brain. You got to activate those nerves. And so how do we do that? Well, we're Harper Natural Health Solution. We're the first office in all of San Diego County to utilize the HockaMed horizontal microcurrent therapy for peripheral neuropathy. This is an amazing piece of equipment. It's a $25,000 piece of equipment that comes from Germany, and it is so amazing. It'll take very sick nerves and bring them alive. And how does it do that? Well, it stimulates the nerve electrically, it blocks pain, it improves blood flow, it stimulates the nerve biochemically, and allows for greater metabolism and healing, and it reduces inflammation locally. Doesn't that sound like all the things that we said that you need to get for your nerves to get better? So the big difference is that there's hundreds of machines out there, and either they're biochemical or bioelectrical. The HockaMed horizontal microcurrent is the only one. It's the state of the art that has both. Every single part of your body heals electrically and chemically. That's what it needs. So when peripheral nerves start to die, they need to be stimulated. And the HockaMed horizontal therapy, that's the best there is. And our office, Harper Natural Health Solutions, again, we were the first ones in all San Diego County to have it and to use it. So what else do we use for nerve repair? Well, we use class 3 low-level lasers. Now, I know people think of lasers as things that are going to cut you and burn you, like in surgery or cutting metal. Well, these are cold lasers. There's no heat associated. And the pulsed energy goes in, and it creates a healing environment. So it's a specific wavelength of light, and it's been clinically, scientifically proven to go into the nerve and stimulate energy production inside the nerve, allowing it to heal. This light also stimulates, ready, microcirculation. Remember what we said, the nerve's got to have the circulation. And it also lymphatic drainage, it gets rid of swelling. The effects are decreased pain, decreased inflammation, and increased tissue growth. So let me show you this here. So here's the laser shooting the photons, and here you can see the damage right here. And so what's happening is you can see the damage is going away. As the damage is going away, we can see, wait, here's the microscopic. The black is the damaged tissue coming off the cartilage and nerve cells. And then right here, we can see the good white stuff going in there, and that causes the healing. So, what else can be done for nerve activation and repair? Well, other than the HockaMed horizontal microcurrent therapy, the class 3 low-level light therapy, the decompression, we do vibration with oxygen. Vibration, you stand on it's called whole body vibration, and it's not one of these little cheapy guys that you stand on that you get from the fairgrounds. This is a medical grade whole body vibration with different frequencies and speeds, and it stimulates the large sensory nerves in the feet and the hands, and it delivers fuel, oxygen, for healing. Amazing piece of equipment. Also, we have what we call take-home PNRT, Peripheral Neuropathy Rehab Therapy Unit, for daily use at home. Now, I have a picture here of a guy in socks using it, but we use a special foot spa that you use with electrolytes, and it works much better. This is a piece of equipment that's yours to get to keep forever. You get to use this every day if you want to from here on out. I want to make sure that not only do we help you get better while you're under care, I'm going to make sure that you stay better while you're done. So what does the rest of the program include? Well, we have essential fatty acid cream, EFAC. This is for inflammation. We rub it on the areas of the damaged nerve, and it helps locally to get rid of inflammation. Also, we have EFAC capsules that you take. And then we have other supplements that will be given to you based upon your blood test and what you need with the results. So key points, it takes many different things to correct peripheral neuropathy. Not just one thing will do it. You gotta do all these things at one time. It's critical. You must address both the underlying metabolic and neurological problems to have success. This condition is progressive and degenerative. I know I said it, and I'll say it again. The symptoms you have right now are only the tip of the iceberg. I can't tell you that people that come in walkers and in wheelchairs, they all say the same thing. Doc, it just started out with some tingling in my toes. I didn't think it was any big deal. Or the people who can't use their hands anymore. Oh, it was just a little bit of numbness in my hands, but it was no big deal. Please get this thing taken care of now. Our peripheral neuropathy program is the most comprehensive and state-of-the-art. It exists in all of Southern California. I know. I got people that call me from all around the United States and Mexico wanting my help because we have something that gets people better and you can't get it anywhere else. So, our specialized comprehensive blood work, looking at the functional ranges to identify metabolic conditions causing peripheral neuropathy, like inflammation, blood sugar, cholesterol problems, placed on an anti-inflammatory diet to allow for healing. The peripheral neuropathy healing and nerve activation versus spinal decompression therapy if you need it. Hakomed horizontal microcurrent therapy, class 3 or 4 low level laser, vibration with the oxygen, EFAC cream and other supplementation. This is for correction, not to cover up your symptoms temporarily. So patients always ask me, how do you know if you can help me? Well, I use this thing that's called the Peripheral Neuropathy Toronto Scoring Test. This was put together by a couple neurologists up in Canada. And what they did is they figured out how we can rate a person's peripheral neuropathy, and we need to know what the number is. And I'll explain to you when you come into the office and do the exam. If you're normal, the normal score is 64. If it's too low, it's too late. If there's too much damage, we will not be able to be accept you as a patient. And I'll be honest with you, and I'll tell you that right up front. So what's next? Well, for you folks that are watching this as a first time and you haven't been into the office or haven't made that appointment yet for your exam, this is what you're going to do. Make an appointment. So I always let everybody know what's going to happen, time and finances, before they come into the office. So you're going to have a conversation with me. We're going to actually sit down and talk for 10 or 15 minutes. I'm not going to ask you a bunch of yes or no questions. I'm going to have you tell me your story. I got to know your story. I got to know what your goals are, so those could be my goals. Comprehensive, complete neurological examination, very thorough. You'll be surprised. Any necessary imaging, if we need to send you out for something, I'll tell you how we can do that. If you have something, bring it in. MRIs, x-rays, those kind of things. Same thing with existing labs. If you have some labs that you have, bring them in. We'll take a look at them. And then you should bring your spouse or significant other if this is applicable. You know, if you guys have kind of a teamwork approach to health, life, you know, make decisions about time and finances together, this person really needs to be there. And on your own, if you're on the other hand, if you're on your own, but you guys stay in the same house, kind of like, you know, one's upstairs watching TV, one's downstairs watching TV, and you're watching the same program, you know, and you make all your own decisions, then that's fine. But again, if you guys make a teamwork approach to this, which is actually best in the long run, that's what you do, is bring the spouse in or a significant other. Case review, if I can accept your care. Only about 2/3 of everybody that comes into my office is allowed to start care with me. Why? Because either I feel like they're not going to follow through and do what I recommend and they're going to make me look bad by not getting better, or their problem is too far gone, they waited too late, and I can't help them at this point. But I'll do my best to try and find somebody who can. So overview of further complete testing to be done, review of the neurological findings from the first day, overview of the treatment plan, review of the investment, and again, be with the spouse. Anytime I talk about your time or your money, I put it in writing. So before you have to make any decisions, you're going to have in writing, and you're going to have a period of time that you're going to be able to review everything in writing, especially the health investment and the health time investment that's involved with this. So this is because of my office time limitations. We only take on 10 peripheral neuropathy patients a month. Usually the first two visits are $250. If you make the appointment after watching this video, or if you've already in here, I'm offering this $250 value for $49. If you reserve your appointment now, if you already have, I'll include 2 days of treatment. That's gonna be the exclusive Hockman horizontal therapy, class 3 or 4 laser, decompression, PNRT, everything that applies to your care and your case. It's very important that we make sure that you're gonna get better with those first visits. I wanna see some improvement. Either you're gonna notice something or I'm gonna notice something, and we're gonna be able to demonstrate that to you. It's very important to make sure that you're gonna get results by doing my care program. What else do you need to do for the first visit? Wear shorts, sweatpants. I need to get to you from the kneecap down to the feet, or from the elbows to the hands. Please, if you've been told to bring paperwork, fill it out completely, get it back to us long before the report. If you're bringing any records, x-rays, MRIs, or if you're gonna go get those things done, get them done now. If you're coming in as a new patient, don't worry about it. We'll get all those things taken care of for you. And again, bring the spouse or significant other if applicable. So I got a few rules here about my PN recovery program. You're gonna have to be willing to make some lifestyle changes. I'm pretty sure for a period of time to get you better, we're gonna have to change what food you eat. I'm pretty sure, all right? That's 99% of all my patients. But you have to take accountability for your own health. I am not like Sears, where you drive in and take out the battery and they put a new battery and you drive out, all right? We have to get you healthy, and I'll show you how to do it, but you have to do it. Now let's talk about insurance. Insurance and Medicare only pays a very small amount, if anything at all. So this is what I say. This is probably what they're gonna pay, somewhere from here to here, somewhere between here and here, all right? So, but don't worry, because 96% of our patients who we can accept into the program are able to afford the care. And we have payment programs. For instance, you can do 18 months interest-free from $200 to $400 a month, depending on your program. If you need to do longer payment programs, we can work that out with you as well. Again, we're gonna have everything in your best interest, and we're gonna put it all in writing for you, because we want you to be happy with our services and get well. 6 things to think about. On a scale of 1 to 10, how serious is this, is your illness? Now again, you may say, oh, this doesn't really bother me very much. Well, that's fine, but I'm gonna let you know it's progressive and degenerative. You know, where do you see yourself in 3 years? I'm gonna play a little video here in a little bit, and this will help bring that home. You know, how's it affected your relationships, your work, your ability to enjoy life? You know, think of 3 things that you could do if you didn't have peripheral neuropathy. On a scale of 1 to 10, how serious are you about getting this problem taken care of? If you're an 8, 9, and 10, we're gonna do great work together. 1 to 7s, I don't have much hope, because you're just not committed enough to getting well. And due to time constraints, again, I can only get those people who are truly committed. So if you're not really committed, you know, to getting healthy, you know, please don't sign up. Please don't go any further with us. I really mean this. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna play this little video for you here, and then I'll come back and finish up.
What will your last 10 years look like? Will you be quick enough for a game of tag with your grandchild? Strong enough to embrace every moment? Will you grow old with vitality? Or get old with disease? It's time to decide.
Every time I see that, it touches me. Every time it reminds me of what could have been for my parents had they gotten the right care, had they not been mishandled by their physicians and medical malpractice take them both away from me. I want to thank you very much for having the time together. I look forward to being of service to you. We'll see you soon.
Sometimes I had a lot of back pain, and I was having bad pains in my hands and my feet and my legs. Leg cramps wake me up at night, and it was just like someone stabbing me with a knife. And I was taking medicine for it, which gradually things got so bad that I was thinking about giving up driving and making other arrangements. I live out in the country, so that really is a problem. Yeah. I think I came in August.
Oh, okay, very good. So a few months. Yeah. And in that period of time, what improvements have you noticed?
Well, my handwriting is better, and I can open a bottle of water.
Good.
And I can snap my fingers. I don't know when I'd ever use it.
Yes. Yeah, I remember when you got here, you couldn't hardly move your fingers properly, and now you can snap them like no problem.
And driving, my hand would go numb, and it would be painful. So while I was at a traffic light, I'd have to put my hands down on my lap and sort of massage them. And
right. So no concern about losing your driver's license, is there?
Not now.
No,
thank goodness.
The leg pain's gone now, right? Is that right?
I haven't had any, those horrible stabbing pains in my feet wake me up at night. And my sleep habits were interrupted.
Right.
Because you get those cramps in your legs and you're trying to sit up to massage your legs and it's...
Oh, it's miserable, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. And you also, your medical doctor's taken you off some medication too,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Yeah, you don't have to take the medication anymore because you're so much healthier.
Yes. Going facing surgery in one hand and then later on in the other hand.
Right. So they wanted to do surgery thinking that you had carpal tunnel.
Yeah.
And did we ever touch your wrist? I mean, did we do any treatment on your wrist specifically?
No.
So that's not where the problem was. So you would have gone and had surgery and still had your problem.
Because, and the feet and legs.
And yes. The feet and legs, right. Do you mind telling me how old you are?
Well, I'll be 89 next week.
89. Yeah. Isn't that amazing?
Well, I've been type 2 diabetic for 2 years. Mm-hmm. 8 years, I'm sorry.
Right.
And my feet were starting to burn and get cold. My legs were getting heavy, and I would get tired really easy walking. I was getting leg cramps at night, and my balance wasn't, I don't think, what it used to be.
Okay.
When I was younger. Well, my numbness and the burning and cold sensation in my feet, it was, I think when I first came in, I described it as about a 9 on a scale of 10.
Right. And pretty bad. Pretty bad.
Yes. And it was about 75% of the time.
Mm-hmm.
Now, after my treatments, that sensation in my feet has gone down to about a 2 on a scale of 10.
Great.
And about 25% of the time. It's not completely gone, but...
Right.
And as far as the... tired and heavy legs, that's much better. I can walk a little brisker now.
Right.
And the sleep, it's about, a big improvement in my restfulness. My rest at night. It's gone from, when I came in, all my symptoms were about a 9 out of 10. And now they're all down to about a 2.
Beautiful.
25% of the time. Oh, also I had balance issues, mm-hmm. and that's a lot better.
Good.
All four issues I had improved tremendously because after the first two treatments, I started to feel better.
Great.
And I wanted to get on with the program.
So yeah, I have CMT in my feet, which contributes to my peripheral neuropathy. And honestly, what really triggered it, I think, was I started to have burning pads of my feet. And that was a new development for me. And I'd seen neurologists and podiatrists and many things over many years. And basically they say, you know, there's really nothing that can be done.
That is so progressive.
I'm just going to live this way. So, and I know others who have this, and my mother-in-law actually has it, and she's on medication, but I knew it was just going to progress. And so the burning pads was a key sign to me that this is where I'm headed for the future. And I, you know, ended up finding Dr. Harper, finding you, and I came in for one of the informational sessions, and certainly intrigued. I mean, the information that was just shared then to me was, you know, fascinating, honestly. I am a due diligent. I deal with contracts all the time, so I read everything, I research everything, and I wouldn't say I was necessarily even skeptical about the treatment or anything like that. But you know, it's something new, and when you have people tell you all the time that you can't change this or heal this, you know, going through the research and reading everything, hearing what you said, everything made sense. Up front, you know, obviously the finances, I was like, okay, but, you know, it makes sense. It made sense. Yeah. So I haven't had burning at all. I don't feel like it's progressed. If anything, I mean, obviously I can feel more. My balance completely changed, and, well, neck pain too.
Even though you're still doing the same job and you have no neck pain
long
now, so we got that all figured out.
Yeah.
And
massages. I get massages now, and it's just totally different to be able to feel my feet and not have, it's just a gross, I couldn't describe it, it's gross, it's just a weird feeling. So now it's miracle sort of stuff. It sounds silly, but you have to try it. I mean, there's clear results. For years, I had gone years and years, and many in Florida and California, multiple neurologists, multiple podiatrists and doctors, and you know, this is your life. I mean, I've even seen I have family members that have trouble with their feet, and, you know, to be able to feel like I've now reversed it, and, you know, you have to try it.
Good job. Well, Karen,
it's worth the investment. It absolutely worth the investment for me.
Beautiful.